Officials of Lira Regional Referral Hospital faced a hard time before the Parliamentary Public Accounts Committee, PAC, as they were put to task to account for fuel worth 35 million shillings that was consumed without evidence of accountability.
Yes, the auditor noted that the hospital incurred fuel expenditure amounting to 35 million, deposited United Bank of Africa cards, but the accounting officer did not provide consumption schedules, printouts, and accountability of evidence of utilization.
Consume fuel using a fuel card, you will know the balance you have on your fuel card. Correct? So now, if what you are telling us, I will not even say was right, I will say we are right. It would imply that at the end of the June, you would be having some prepayment somewhere, some receivable somewhere.
According to the Auditor General's report, the hospital accrued fuel expenditure amounting to 35.29 million shillings deposited on United Bank for Africa, UBA, cards, but their accounting officer fell short of consumption schedules and printout for accountability.
Because the response seems to indicate that the fuel had been consumed and there were accountability documents. The second response we get from, I was not around, so I didn't pick the names at introduction, was that the fuel had not been consumed. Did they have accountability documents in anticipation of consuming the fuel?
Accountability documents are available for verification. It means the fuel has been consumed.
It seems your whispering is not leading us anywhere. Silence, according to Cyrus, Honorable, just that silence is a communication. It amounts to either acceptance or...
Despite several attempts to explain the query, officials failed to provide proper accountability before the Public Accounts Committee, which prompted a section of MPs to propose that money be recovered from the accounting officer and the hospital accountant.
The accountabilities that were submitted to my office partially were for G2G, for activities which are still running, and some were for government which had not been surveyed at that time.
Yeah, this is not reconcilable. This is a pure financial loss.
But the committee vice chairperson, Asman Basalira, gave officials a second chance to avail more documents before close of business on Tuesday, the 25th of July, before the committee takes a final decision on the matter.
Can you work through this, and we have a response by end of the day Tuesday.
As if lack of accountability for fuel was not enough, the committee established that amount worth 24.2 million shillings was paid to some suppliers to settle domestic arrears which were not supported neither recognized in the books of the hospital.
Payment of unsupported domestic arrears. It was noted that 24.2 million relating to payment of supplies and works executed in the financial year 2020-21 was expended as part of the current year expenditure.
Yes. Actually, you diverted, you mischarged paying the area that were not there. Just accounting officer, just imagine you have crossed the financial year with those services you needed to pay for are equivalent to 4.5 million. But when the financial year begins, you budget for 118 million and they give it to you.
Public Accounts Committee also queried Lira Hospital for awarding a contract of worksman compensation to MSUAP Old Mutual Insurance Uganda Limited using a wrong procurement method. The Auditor General established that there was no contract management plan, no contract management report, and no clearance obtained from the Solicitor General.
Zero use of wrong procurement methods. It was noted that a contract with that reference number for workman's compensation and medical insurance of 86 staff and 3 dependents was awarded to Old Mutual on 26 April 2022. However, review of procurement documents, budget and work plans revealed irregularities.
If, for example, you have not sought clearance from the regional on a contract, you have not followed the PPDA regulations and guidelines.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.